This extraordinary year has shown us that wherever we step back, the space we leave is providing wildlife with new opportunities.
This pandemic can help us take a step back and assess the relationship that humans want to have with the natural world.
Juneau is a premier whale watching destination. In a typical year, we'll have about 1.3 million people visit by cruise ship. And of those, a quarter of them will board smaller boats to go on whale watching trips. This year, we essentially have zero.
This year is a really incredible opportunity as a scientist to collect data in the absence of a lot of boats on the water that we can then compare to previous and future years of normal whale watching activity.
The number of whale watching boats around a whale increases the amount of sound that a whale is exposed to. Therefore, there's the potential for whales to be more stressed out than they would if they had less disturbance around them.
The goal of the study is to determine what is the stress hormone level of these whales during this unusual year.
What we're looking for is the concentration of a steroid hormone called cortisol, and we recognize this as stress.
Power two, safety off. Let's try and get a little bit closer.
When we're collecting our data, we believe we have a fairly minimal impact on the whale. So the biopsy samples that we take, I compare that to getting a finger prick at the doctor's office. So it hurts for just a split second, but then after that, you're fine and you forget about it.
We fire this towards the animal. It hits into the side of the animal, and then it bounces off and floats in the water.
It's leaking blubber.
And when we get it, we have skin and blubber in this coring end.
So I'll just hold onto it, okay. You twist.
It's a pretty small sample, a little smaller than the eraser end of a pencil.
I think we got it all.
All right,
nice job.
Good sample.
Our results might help to inform management regulations and guidelines for humpback whales in Juneau. So perhaps changes to the number of boats around whales, how long boats stay with whales, and overall how many boats are on the water. This moment provides a really unique opportunity to understand the natural state of whales and other wildlife around the globe.
We have an opportunity to slow down a little bit and think about how we interact with wildlife and what that might look like with a little bit more intention.